Are you in Vegas already?
I am, yes. I got here last night. And yeah, all set in, you know, starting that fight week feeling over here. I mean, it's been already, it's Sunday, but yeah.
Yeah. So that's when fight week kind of feels like it starts for you, is Sunday?
Yeah, Sunday it is. You know, that's when I start the week. So it's kind of where everything starts to take place and the feeling and everything. But for sure, when I get to the hotel, in this case, Vegas, it's more like, okay, it's fight week.
I've got my cat here just in case he's going to climb on me. So I want to ask you, I noticed you've been training with Glover out in Connecticut. Like, can you kind of tell me like how that came about and what's it been like out there?
It's been amazing. It was a great experience. I loved it. You know, I finished my camp there and just the energy there, honestly, was amazing. My first time over there in Connecticut as well. So I had the opportunity, I learned a lot. And I had the fortune as well that I was in the same, I'm in the same fight card as Alex Poatan, who's, he's fighting. So we were both, you know, focused on our fights and everyone was training hard for it, you know, and there's other guys over there that are preparing for fights. So it was, you know, it felt very, very well. It was just great.
So how did that come about? Like, how did you find your way over there? Did they reach out to you? Did you reach out to them? How'd that come about?
I reached out to them. My boyfriend knew Alex Poatan over here in California. So that's when the connection started. His manager, Jorinha, was the one who made like that connection, because Alex came here, we met each other, and then, you know, months after we're here, with the opportunity to go there and meet them. I met Glover before, but as a fan, you know, and then I had the opportunity to go over there and just meet him and train with him, and just, you know, it's mind shocking. You know, he's so humble. He's just like, he has a fight coming up and he's thinking and helping you and like stopping his training to, you know, give you advice and like guide you. So I don't know, it felt very natural. It fit very well, honestly. And I feel like it's a great beginning for me.
Do you think you'll continue to go over there for training camps, or was it sort of just a one-time special thing?
I think so. You know, I'm not closed for possibilities. And honestly, I was looking for that perfect place for me, and I have everything there. You know, there's this girl that she's going to be in my corner, actually, Aline, that's Poatan's sister, and she is a kickboxer, like high level, you know, and she's my size. It's very rare to find another girl my size in, you know, in the business. It's hard, you know. So it was an opportunity for me to really actually train hard with another woman and the same size, you know. So definitely, like you said, I'm open. I still have a few months of rent in California, but you know, after that I'm definitely thinking of moving.
Oh, so it could be like a full-time thing, not just a training camp thing.
Yeah,
you like snow?
You know, but I'm focused a lot, like, in this fight, you know. I enjoyed over there a lot, and it was very different for me, the winter and everything. So I'm just energized, you know, when you go for the first time to this place, and you have so much to be grateful for, you know, training and just the energy. So I don't know, I'm focused, and I'm taking all that energy for the fight, and after the fight, we'll decide, you know, that doesn't really matter.
Yeah. So you have a new opponent. You know, at what point was there any point where, you know, you find out your opponent is not going to fight? Was there any time where you thought maybe the fight wouldn't happen, or did they give you a new opponent right away?
Oh, no, it was 1 hour of actually half an hour of terror for me. I was like, oh, no, I want to fight, you know, and then I was like, I'm going to just relax. I'm going to go train, continue my work. Because we still have time, you know, it's not like a week notice, you know, that will be probably hard to find, you know, but I was kind of having the expectation, and I was kind of sure, I had that feeling that the fight was going to happen, you know, a fight was going to eventually happen. So I continue my training, and then next day I was already signing the new contract. So it didn't really took long, and I really appreciate that from Miranda, because it's been months of work for me, you know, and I want to fight. I want to, you know, show the world all this hard work that I've been doing. So, you know, I just appreciated that she took the place and accept the fight.
What were your thoughts when you heard it was going to be her? Were you, you know, was it a fight that you were maybe more excited about, or like, hey, I just, like you said, I just want to fight. I don't care who it is. Like, what were you thinking when that name came up?
You know, I like to always watch what's happening in the flyweight division. You know, I'm always interested. There's so many flyweight fights almost every weekend. So I already knew who she was, you know, and I already wanted to fight her for a long time. I want to fight everyone in the division. So for me, it was a great news, you know, because I'm going to fight her. If in the future I find again Mandy Boom, I will, you know, but I don't know if more exciting. I just feel like it's a challenge, and you got to make adjustments and, you know, keep going. But a fight is a fight. So, yeah, I'm happy.
And are you one to make predictions? Can you give us a prediction for the fight?
Oh, man, I want to finish her, you know, TKO. I think that's my prediction.
Awesome. And then one last question. Right now, kind of a big news topic in sports is there was an NFL player who was suspended for betting on himself, basically. And, you know, in MMA, that's not a thing. You can bet on yourself as long as you're not betting to lose. And I have a betting show. And one of the things we talk about is, you know, fighters talking to bettors about why they should bet on you. So I'm wondering if you can tell me why you think bettors should put money on you for this fight.
Well, you know, first of all, when you step in the cage, you're always thinking that you want to win, and yes, for sure, you know, and I will definitely bet on myself, you know, just because I know the hard work I did. I know how hard I work in absolutely all the parts of MMA, even jiu-jitsu, wrestling, everything, you know. So I don't know, I feel like I have that confidence, and I will definitely do it, you know. But I'm not a huge betting person. I actually want to get more into it, you know, because I've never really done it. But I can make sure that there's going to be an exciting fight, and that I'll just give it all for that victory. I'll give my heart, my blood, whatever it takes. But, you know, I'm going to step in there and show a little bit of the Colombian queen.
Thank you so much. I really appreciate it. Have a good day, and I will see you soon.
Thank you very much. Have a great day.